What about Dostoevsky? I mean, what? I mean, because you hold him in such high regard.
Because you know, Friedrich Nietzsche. He say about Dostoevsky, he's the only writer that when he reads him, he has the feeling that he understands better the human soul. And when I read Dostoevsky, I understand better the psychology of the human being. He goes very, very far into the psychology, and he has a sense of humor, and he gives his personal point of view. He's never trying, you know, to show how objective he is. He is completely subjective, and it teaches me about what human being is, you know. Dostoevsky changed my life, and there are some books that I read, and, it's just like water on a duck, you know. It just doesn't touch me at all. It's very beautiful, but I'm like, what have I learned from that? Nothing. You know, but, you know, when I read, you know, a poetry of Khayyam, for example, it changed my vision of life. I don't want to live the same way. I want to be like him, so it make me grow up. He's the one that in the
Crime and Punishment.
Okay, Crime and Punishment, he gives the best reason why we should be against the death penalty. I have never read that nowhere else. He says that even if you are a soldier, you're in a fight, and in front of you, you have 5,000 soldiers. You always have the hope that you might get through it, you know. Miracle can happen, and you might be able to kill all these 5,000 and get through it. But when you're condemned to death, this hope does not exist. And this little moment of hope, when you can imagine that you might survive, you don't have the right to take it from any human being. And he wrote that in the 19th century, and I think this is...
And he writes that also from the point of view of someone who was nearly killed.
Absolutely.
And who was graced by the Tsar, who was coming by and...
Exactly, exactly.